Hello, this is Jack from No Code MBA and welcome to this video where we're going to compare two very popular website builders, Card and Squarespace. And stay to the end because I'm going to go through exactly who these platforms are for and some of the use cases that you can use. And before we dive in, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new here. And also check out the description for a couple of things. First, a free guide on different no-code tools that you can use for your business. And also more information about the courses that we currently offer. All right, so on your screen you can see Card versus Squarespace. And I'm just going to give a quick overview just to set the tone for this video before going into the features and the pricing, etc. So Card, this is a free platform for building simple, fully responsive one-page sites for pretty much anything. And I've also just done a Card review recently where you can look at some of the templates that Card uses and some of the use cases. But in summary, this is for people who want to build that one-page website where it's really simple, it's responsive, and something that has a low learning curve to it. So anyone can just dive in and use Card. Now the next one, Squarespace, their tagline is easily create a website or online store. So this second part is quite important. It's a little bit more in depth in terms of e-commerce as we're going to see in a minute. Now let's talk about pricing. So Card, it is free for a subdomain where it's something like petetheplumber.card.co. And then they have some options as well for pricing. And at the moment, this might change. You can check out the pricing. It's either $9.19 or $49 a year for a custom domain and some advanced features like no branding and some plugins, forms, etc. Now with Squarespace, the last time I looked, there's a free trial, but no free version. And the pricing is between $16 and $49 a month for features such as e-commerce and subscriptions. Now they have monthly no contract pricing, and also pay monthly, but you're tied in for a year. So that pricing does change somewhat. So you can see here, straight off the bat, Card is the more affordable option, and Squarespace is more expensive. So let's talk about some of the benefits of Card. Now, the first one is it's simple to use. Super simple to use. They have a bunch of templates for you, where you can just go in, choose a template. There's not a lot of things to look at there, not a lot of advanced features with it. So it's super simple to use. Its main focus is on building one-page websites. Things like the online business card, where you can think of it like Linktree, where you kind of link to different things. But you can also think of it as well as for landing pages too. And it can integrate with payment systems such as Stripe and PayPal and Gumroad. So it does offer some e-commerce capability, but this is quite limited in scope. And then you can also create landing pages where you can embed forms to collect emails. So think of a landing page that you can build. You can easily do this with Card and then collect emails and offer for in exchange for a lead magnet or a subscription, email subscription. And like most website builders these days, it's fully responsive. So it's just going to automatically change the dimensions and just fit well with a mobile device, an iPad, tablets, and laptops too. And like we've already mentioned, it's probably the most affordable website builder that I've come across. Now, Squarespace benefits here. It's easy to create beautiful designs. So it's a little bit more advanced in terms of the templates that you're going to see. And again, it's like a drag and drop, template based, edit it on page, very simple to use and easy to create. So both of those are quite similar. But one of the differences here is that Squarespace lends itself to more multi-page websites, where you can have different pages on the website and also blogging too. It's responsive, like most are. It has a more advanced e-commerce functionality. So think about membership websites or selling products on the website. And this comes with the more advanced plans, but everything integrates with Squarespace. Whereas other website builders, you might need a different plugin or then use something like Teachable as an extra add-on. Squarespace integrates all of this together. And then there are lots of templates. Lots and lots of templates for you to use. So you can just choose your template and then customize it to fit whatever it is that you're offering. Now, we'll talk about some of the drawbacks, starting with card first. And think of this more of, when it comes to website builders, it's not a one website builder is going to be perfect for you. Instead, card has its own benefits for it and use cases and Squarespace as well. But I think this part is important because if you're thinking about more advanced features or think about things here, then it might not be right for you. The first one is you can't export code. So it's not a website builder like Webflow where you can create the website and then export that code to then use it somewhere else. You can't do that with card. It's not as customizable. It's very simple in the way that it wants people to use it. So when you're building a one-page website builder, it's not as customizable in terms of getting the CSS code just how you like it. And there's no content management system either. And we'll talk about some different website builders that you can use later in the video that has this feature. Now, with Squarespace, you don't have full control over the design. So when it's a template-based website builder, then you're kind of limited in a certain way to what that template is and the colors, etc. Not the colors, but the coding, etc. So it's, again, it's a little bit more limited, but that can help a lot of people. It could be a benefit for a lot of people because they don't want to go in depth with that. They want to use a template, and you might be the same without thinking, okay, I need to change this, I need to change that. Now, there's no content management system, again, no CMS here. And we'll look at some more examples of website builders that have this functionality if it's important to you. Now, use cases. Card. I think a great use case here is a simple website with full control over how it looks in the design in terms of the colors you're going to use, the images, the fonts, the headlines, etc. So simple web pages, websites. Think of an About Me page, one landing page, a simple e-commerce website where people can use something like Gumroad to purchase something from you, and you can embed those forms and links in there. So a big use case here is a landing page, like we talked about, where you have a lead magnet, people click put in their email, and then they sign up to get that lead magnet. And then another one is simple e-commerce websites. Think about something integrating with Stripe or PayPal or Gumroad, and you have a sales page, a one sales page. This could be we looked at an example in the card review where someone was selling a add-on to the MacBook where you can look at your Stripe payments coming in. So think of it as a very simple e-commerce website. Now, Squarespace, we like to think of it as a business website where you have a doctor's office with 5 web pages or a local cleaning service with 5 pages where people can get in touch with you. They can even pay online. They can use calendar, embeds, etc. So think of local business websites, also portfolios too. It's big in the photography industry where people use it as a way to show their portfolio and then sell their prints online. Again, we can use Squarespace as a landing page where you have your website and then you can add a landing page where you send people to that site in order to take action. Blogging. Great for blogging too. So you can set up a blog in the back end and then create your articles to go on the Squarespace website. And then in relation to card, it's a little bit more like advanced e-commerce websites. So think about memberships that integrate into the Squarespace platform. And then let's talk about overall recommendation. Card, simple one-page websites. And you can also think about it as testing out an idea. So if you're unsure about which one to use, know that both of them offer hosting. You can get your custom domain, point it to Card to begin with, and then you might want to upgrade at a different point, and then you can use Squarespace or maybe Webflow at a later date. So it's a good way to get started with one-page websites and then see where you go from there. And then Squarespace, we like to think of it as using it for simple business websites, 5-page website for a local business. Also e-commerce solutions where you have a member area and blogging too. Now, if you're thinking about, okay, these two seem limited in scope, in terms of allowing me to expand in the future, then consider something like Webflow, which is a bit more complex, but at the same time, Card and Squarespace are much easier to use. So it all depends on you, your goals, and what you want to do moving forward. Now, be sure to check out the description as well for more comparisons on our website. And I'll leave a link there so you can check out comparisons such as Webflow versus Squarespace, Webflow versus Card. We can even throw Bubble in there as well if you want to learn about that too. And again, if you're new here, then be sure to subscribe to the channel. And before you go, check out the different videos on your screen now to learn more about no-code tools and building businesses with no-code tools. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye.